showing you how to do crosstab reports in FileMaker. I'm going to go over two different methods, one using native FileMaker and one using a web viewer, and kind of go over the pros and cons of both of those. So here is maybe a traditional crosstab report that you might want to do, where you want to show your companies across the top and your categories down the side, and then groupings of cells. So in this example, you have to select which companies you want to compare. So let's just choose a couple. So as you can see, I mean, that works pretty good, but remember, I'm just using a local file and I don't have that many records. This can be a little slow if you have a lot of records running over the server, and it's not as flexible as I would like in some respects. You can only do as many columns as fields and relationships you build. So right now I've only built 3, so I can only ever compare 3. And as you see, it takes a little bit of work. You have your global ID selection field over on the category. This is the table that we're on. And we have 3 relationships to all the sales data based on the customer ID you select and what category the row is. So we had to build 3 relationships, and we had to build 3 global ID fields and 3 calculations to total up the cells. So that can definitely get a little messy if you have to do a bunch of columns, and is not capable of doing infinite columns if that is something that you need to do. So let me go ahead and show you the web viewer now, the same report. Well, not exactly the same. Well, as you can see, we have all of our companies across the top, and we're breaking it down by category, and we're also breaking it down by year, which this would be very difficult to do in FileMaker, but it's not too bad if you're just using a web viewer. And as you can see, this whole thing is a web viewer. I know they look very similar, but that's just CSS styling. So let's go over how I built this real quick. And I'm actually gonna kind of focus on maybe more of a simple example. There's a service called Rapid Tables that can kind of get you started with building tables. So as you can see here, rapidtables.com, they have a HTML table generator. And you know, you could go in here and build your style if you wanted your background color to, oops. There we go. Let's say we wanted a nice red. You know, you can go in there and do stuff like that, get it how you want it styled, and it'll spit out all the code for you. So let me go back to my FileMaker example, and we'll go to Rapid Tables. And as you can see, I just copied that earlier and threw it into a web browser, or into a web viewer. And all I added really was this data colon text slash HTML comma, and then the rest of the HTML it spit out. I also added just some body tags and HTML tags. But this is all just spit out right there. And once you do that, it's just a matter of replacing this with your data. So using a script, you could generate your table rows for the header. So this could be category, year, and then, you know, your different companies would go here. So Apple, then you could do one for Google underneath it. So TH stands for table header. So you can just keep adding these rows as you want, one after another. And then inside the table body, we have our table row. And then inside that, we have our table data. So these just mean spaces. No breaking space is what that means. So category would be phone, maybe. Year could be 2017. For Apple, they did like a billion. So we'll just put, oops, we'll just put 100B because I don't want to type it all out. And once we go into browse mode, you can see, oh yeah, there it is. You know. So that is the concept. You're just building text, and I'm doing that all with a script. So in this generate HTML, that's all I'm doing. You'll notice very similar things. This is my table header. So table row, table header, category year. And then I'm looping through each of my company records to create the rest of the table headers. So loop through and add to header another header with the company name. Loop through each record and stop when you're done. And then I loop through the types to get the different categories. And while I'm looping through the categories, I loop through the different years. And then while I'm looping through the years, I loop through the customer to get the sum, basically the total. So I'm just summing up a relationship. So this, all this really only took one relationship. And that relationship is from customer to sale. So while I'm doing the looping, I'm just updating a global for the year and the type. So go to each one, change the year, change the type, sum up my total price, or yeah, my price, sum it up, go to the next year and category, sum up my price, do that over and over again for each different possibility, and just add a table data for each one, make sure it's in the same, the right spot. It's really not too bad once you understand the basic structure, and I think that rapid tables can really help with that. And after that, I just set the HTML header and the HTML table fields with that. And as you'll see in here, I'm pulling that right here. So inside my table header, I want my HTML header, and in my body, I want my HTML body. And so one last thing I'm going to show you is just kind of the flexibility of what this allows you to do. So let me go ahead and change a sale. Let's say this sale from Amazon actually took place in 2013. When I go back to my example and refresh, you'll see that the report now goes from 2013 to 2017. Let's say I wanted to add another company. I can just go to customer, let's do a new one, just make a new FileMaker one, and when I Oh, I gotta actually make a cell for them. So let's change that to FileMaker. Oops. And let me refresh that. So FileMaker in 2013 sold a computer, it looks like. it's very flexible. And one thing that is a little bit of a challenge is printing a web viewer. I don't know if you've ever tried to. But when you go into preview mode, which is what you print, you know, quite often you get nothing. So in order to kind of combat that, one way to do it is to print actually from the web browser, from the user's web browser. So this print button I've built, all it's doing is it's exporting the contents of this web viewer, and it's just attaching a little bit of JavaScript to the end. And that script is just says window.print. So that's really all it is to it. And then I've added specific styling specifically for printing in here. So that's why it's a little longer than normal, because I have a secondary style for media print. Basically just makes it fit on a page a little bit better. So let me show you that. So it opens up my web browser, and this is the print layout. So, you know, it's a pretty good looking report, and I didn't really have to do much. All I did was change some CSS style, and now I'm ready for print. So, definitely like this technique and think it'll offer a lot of flexibility. So, thank you for watching.